Hello all, so now let's welcome back to Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series. So now we will be discussing about the rapid MCQ revision series about antiviral drugs. Okay, among antiviral, we will be discussing in very great detail about HIV virus, the drugs for HIV virus, and all other viruses like hepatitis B and C virus, herpes simplex virus, influenza virus, respiratory syncytial virus, papilloma virus, and certain miscellaneous other viruses along with it. Okay, so keeping this thing in mind, let's solve the question number first. Ganciclovir is preferred over acyclovir in the following condition. Remember, if the drug is having cyclovir word in it, remember if cyclovir word is coming, remember any drug which ends with the word cyclovir is for herpes group of virus. Okay, any drug which is ending with the word cyclovir will be for herpes group of virus. And the answer for this question we will mark is that it is given for cytomegalovirus, because in cytomegalovirus, acyclovir is not effective. So the answer for this question is D. Keeping this thing in mind, let's talk about anti-herpes drug. Okay, let's talk about anti-herpes drug. So if you talk about anti-herpes drug, let's classify herpes group of virus into various types. So first, you are seeing on the left side in the pink, it is herpes simplex virus 1, herpes simplex virus 2, and varicella zoster virus VZV. For all of these three viruses, the drug of choice is acyclovir. And we have modified acyclovir into various forms like valacyclovir, pencyclovir, and famicyclovir. Remember, this acyclovir and its congeners are not effective in cytomegalovirus. In cytomegalovirus, the drug of choice is ganciclovir. Okay, but remember, ganciclovir is effective against the viruses where acyclovir is approved. But remember, ganciclovir is not right now approved for herpes simplex 1, 2, and varicella zoster, but it is found to be effective. Now, the ganciclovir congeners are also there, like valganciclovir. And there are two new drugs for cytomegalovirus, that is fomivirsane and letermovir. Fomivirsane is an antisense oligonucleotide. Okay, letermovir is a type of mRNA inhibitor. Now, for acyclovir and ganciclovir resistant cases, for all these viruses, in resistant cases, the drug of choice is foscarnet. Okay, there is one more drug which can be given, that is cidofovir. So this is a brief summary in nutshell of the treatment of all herpes group of viruses. So the answer for our question comes out to be ganciclovir is given for cytomegalovirus, while all other viruses we give acyclovir. Keeping this thing in mind, these are the certain topical drugs for herpes simplex virus. So the mnemonic is vitamin CD. Vitamin VIT word we have taken, vidarabine, idoxuridine, trifluridine, cidofovir, and docosinol. Remember this idoxuridine, vidarabine, and first three drugs, and they are never given by systemic route because they are highly toxic. Like idoxuridine, it is highly cardiotoxic. Hence, it is only given topical for herpes labialis, herpes keratitis, the infections of the lips, the infection of cornea, etc. Now, if you talk about acyclovir, it's an oral drug, it's a prodrug, and it is the drug of choice for herpes simplex virus. And the dose is given, it is not very important to remember the dose, but remember it is given 5 times a day. The side effect of acyclovir is neurotoxic and nephrotoxic, but remember it does not cause bone marrow suppression. Bone marrow suppression is the main side effect of ganciclovir. Okay, then we have ganciclovir. So let's talk about foscarnet first. Foscarnet is given in resistant cases of acyclovir and ganciclovir. It is an inorganic pyrophosphatase. It inhibits the conversion of nucleotide 3-phosphatase attachment to DNA. Okay, and it is given against all herpes group of virus, and it is the drug of choice for acyclovir and ganciclovir resistant cases. The side effect of foscarnet is just like acyclovir, neurotoxic and nephrotoxic, not bone marrow suppression. In nephrotoxicity, remember, it leads to loss of all ions like hypocalcemia, hypomagnesemia, hypokalemia, all ions are lost. So acyclovir and ganciclovir do not cause bone marrow suppression. Ganciclovir mainly causes bone marrow suppression. Then we have a drug, cidofovir. Cidofovir is a fake cytidine analog, and it is given against all DNA viruses like acyclovir resistant cases, ganciclovir resistant cases. It is a drug of choice for papillomatosis, papilloma virus. Okay, so papilloma virus causes respiratory papillomatosis, adenovirus, molluscum contagiosum, BK virus, which causes opportunistic infection in renal transplant patient. And remember, right now we have modified the cidofovir. Our new drug is brincidofovir. It has recently been approved for smallpox virus. Now, like ganciclovir, it also causes bone marrow suppression. So this is the summary of the treatment of papilloma virus, condyloma, which causes condyloma acuminata, warts. So self-administered creams are there like podophyllotoxin, imiquimod, and cinecatechins. By a doctor, cryotherapy, lasers, interferons, keratolytic surgeries. So these are generally given. Okay, so these are topical lesions. For respiratory papillomatosis, we give cidofovir. Now these are the preventive human papilloma virus vaccines are there. Bivalent, cervarix, which is against human papilloma virus strain 16 and 18. These are the most dangerous strain which causes cervical carcinoma. It is given for age group of 9 to 25 years. Then we have a quadrivalent vaccine, Gardasil. It contains 6-11 plus 16-18, just like cervarix. So it is given for 9 to 26 years of age. Both are given intramuscularly, 3 doses, 016 and 026. Gardasil 9 is a new vaccine in which we have added certain other strains as well. 5 more strains are there, 31, 33, 45, 52 and 58. It is given for 15 to 26 years age, and the dosage is just like the above Gardasil. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. So let's solve the second question. Acyclovir is given in. We already know the answer. Acyclovir, cyclovir word comes. The answer is herpes simplex. Cyclovir word, herpes simplex. Now drug of choice for herpes simplex virus, we already know, is acyclovir. Okay. Now, avian influenza is treated by. The answer for this question is oseltamivir. Remember, any drug which ends with the word mivir is given for influenza virus. Okay, so cyclovir word means herpes, mivir word means influenza. Okay, so let's talk about the treatment of influenza virus now. Now for influenza, we have mainly two types of drug, one which inhibit the entry and one will inhibit the exit of virus. The entry inhibitors are known as M2 proton inhibitors. They inhibit the shedding of viral envelope. The drugs are amantadine and rimantadine. Then we have a drug, a neuraminidase inhibitor. Neuraminidase is an enzyme which is present on the surface of influenza virus. It is required for assembly of viral protein so that this virus can come out of the cell. So for complete description, what are these enzymes? You have to see the complete video. Now remember, M2 proton inhibitors, they are amantadine and rimantadine, and neuraminidase inhibitor, they will end with the word mivir, like oseltamivir, zanamivir, piramivir, leninamivir. Now the drug of choice for influenza straight away have become neuraminidase inhibitor. The reason is M2 proton inhibitor, they are only effective against one strain of influenza, that is influenza A, while neuraminidase inhibitor, they are effective in all types of influenza. Influenza A, which causes epidemic pandemics, influenza B, which causes epidemics, H1N1 type of influenza A known as swine flu, H5N1, which is avian flu, spread through pigs, spread through birds, etc. Now the side effect, remember, amantadine have been approved in Parkinson's disease also, for levodopa induced dyskinesia, that we will be discussing in CNS part. Now the second point is, side effect of amantadine, rimantadine are the most common side effect. They are given orally, hence they cause nausea and vomiting. In CNS, remember, they cause seizures because they increase the level of various neurotransmitters like glutamate, etc. It causes peptic ulcers and glaucoma because they increase the release of catecholamines like dopamine, noradrenaline, which can lead to all these side effects. Now remember, it is contraindicated in renal failure, epilepsy and peptic ulcers. Now, if you talk about how to remember these drugs, oseltamivir means oral drug. Side effect will be nausea and vomiting and diarrheas. Zanamivir, na means it is given nasally. Why? Because it has a very poor oral absorption. It cannot be given orally. So when inhaling, the side effect will be asthma. Piramivir and leninamivir are given parenterally. They are given by injection. Leninamivir is the longest acting drug. Their common side effect is they can cause fibrosing or interstitial lung disease. Okay. So these are influenza. Now the drug of choice for influenza treatment is, remember, treatment and prophylaxis of both influenza treatment as well as prophylaxis is oseltamivir. Treatment must be started within 2 days of infection, and prophylaxis, remember, for at least 4 weeks. After one case, in community is found. Okay, the drug of choice is oseltamivir. Remember, oseltamivir for treatment is given 75 milligram BD. BD means twice a day for 5 days, and for prophylaxis it is given once a day for 7 days. So how to remember BD? Second, you will remember 5. OD means once, so first letter you will remember the word 7. Okay, so this is the treatment of influenza. Now let's talk about the next question. Resistance to acyclovir is due to. Now let's see the mechanism of action of acyclovir. Now remember, both acyclovir and ganciclovir, they are fake guanine analog. Now the point is, they enter into human cell in which virus is there. Okay. Now first of all, these fake guanine on them, first phosphate is attached. And then two more phosphates are attached. It will form guanosine 3-phosphate. Now this guanosine 3-phosphate is a type of fake nucleotide. Now this fake nucleotide can go into viral DNA and can incorporate into viral DNA, and a defective viral DNA will be formed because this DNA polymerase enzyme will not able to distinguish between the normal nucleotide and a fake nucleotide. So this DNA polymerase will not able to understand about this fake nucleotide, and there will be defective DNA synthesis. Okay, defective DNA synthesis. Now the catch out here is, this guanine will be converted into guanosine monophosphate by an enzyme known as viral thymidine kinase enzyme. So this phosphate is attached by a viral kinase enzyme, and the next two phosphates are attached by human kinase enzyme. Human thymidine kinase enzyme. Okay, so can we say it will only affect those cells which are human cells which are having virus in it? Okay, so it is a specific drug for viral incorporated human cells. Now what is the cause of resistance? The cause of resistance is due to mutation in viral thymidine kinase. If there is some mutation in viral thymidine kinase, can we say that this fake guanine will not be converted into guanosine monophosphate? So this is the main cause of resistance to acyclovir. That is, resistant mutation in viral thymidine kinase is the main. So the point out here is, resistant to acyclovir is most commonly due to mutation in viral gene that encodes for a protein which is responsible for phosphorylation of acyclovir. So acyclovir is a fake guanine. It will not be converted into guanine monophosphate. Okay. Now the drug which causes complete histopathological resolution in a patient of hepatitis B virus is. So which of the following is an hepatitis B virus drug? The answer is entecavir. Okay. Entecavir. Now remember, for hepatitis B virus, remember there are two drug of choice. One is tenofovir. They are the first line drug. And second is entecavir. Because they are the most effective drug, they can cause complete histopathological resolution. We can also give injectable interferon alpha. So let's talk about now hepatitis virus. Remember, in hepatitis we give only treatment of HBV and HCV. Other type of hepatitis viruses A, D, E and G, they don't require any treatment. So let's talk about the drugs for hepatitis group of virus. Okay, so let's talk about hepatitis group of virus. So there are two viruses, hepatitis B virus, which is a DNA virus, and hepatitis C virus, which is an RNA virus. In hepatitis B and C virus, we have a common injectable drug, that is interferon alpha 2A and 2B. Okay. Now, for other drugs for hepatitis B and C virus are oral drugs. In hepatitis B virus, we have reverse transcriptase inhibitors. So the drugs are, you can write a mnemonic, Tectal, tenofovir, entecavir, clavudine, telbivudine, edifovir and lamivudine. The best drug we have is tenofovir followed by entecavir. Okay, then we have oral drug for HCV. The first drug is ribavirin, which is an RNA polymerase inhibitor. Now we have new drug which are known as NS inhibitor. NS stands for non-structural protein inhibitors. So we have NS3 and 4A inhibitor. They will end with the word Previr, because NS3 and 4A enzyme is a type of protease enzyme. So they are protease inhibitor. They end with the word Prevair, like Cimeprevir, Bosiprevir, Telaprevir, Grazoprevir, Asunaprevir, Peritaprevir. You just have to identify them. Then we have NS5A inhibitor. They will end with the word Aswir. So mnemonic is Loved, Ledipaswir, Ombitaswir, Velpatasvir, Elbasvir, and Declatasvir. NS5A, remember, is a type of replication complex. It is an assembly of ribosome with mRNA. Then we have NS5B inhibitor. NS5B inhibitor, the drugs are Sofosbuvir and Dasabuvir. It is a type of RNA polymerase enzyme. Okay, so these are the overall drugs, and all these NS inhibitors, remember, they are oral drugs. So this is the complete list of HBV and HCV drugs. Okay, so let's see the treatment. Let's talk about the first drug, that is interferon. Remember, interferons are of three types, alpha, beta, and gamma. Here in hepatitis infection, we are using interferon alpha. But remember, interferon beta, where it is used? Interferon beta is used in multiple sclerosis. Okay, it is the main drug for multiple sclerosis, relapsing remitting type. We also give interferon gamma for chronic granulomatous disease, osteopetrosis, renal cell carcinoma, and Friedreich ataxia. Now, interferon alpha, remember, it has both antiviral as well as anti-cancer property. Now, they are used in viruses like hepatitis B virus, hepatitis C virus, and human papilloma virus known as condyloma. So these are the three antiviral use. It is also used in cancers, mainly those cancers which are viral induced. So lymphomas like hairy cell leukemia, malignant melanoma, follicular lymphoma, and Kaposi sarcoma. So you know that hairy cell leukemia, Epstein-Barr virus are associated with that. The main side effect is flu-like symptom. Remember, when we have a viral infection, the symptoms of viral infection are due to production of interferon in our body. So these are flu-like symptoms. They cause bone marrow suppression, depression, hypothyroidism, hepatotoxic, and neurotoxic. Okay. Now, these are the common drugs for hepatitis B and C virus, that is interferon alpha. Hepatitis BV and HIV virus, LET, but remember, amitriptyline is right now not approved for HBV, it is only given for HIV. But amitriptyline has been found to be effective in hepatitis B virus. HCV and RSV is ribavirin. Okay, so this is the guidelines for treatment of HCV, which is not very important for you. Just try to remember the first one, that is Sofosbuvir and Velpatasvir. They are given for all genotypes of HCV. It is given for 12 weeks and it can cause complete resolution of HCV virus. This is about ribavirin. Ribavirin is a broad spectrum antiviral drug. It is mainly given for all RNA viruses. So HCV are respiratory syncytial virus, hemorrhagic fever caused by all RNA viruses. It is a very dangerous drug. Okay. And these are the guidelines for HBV, which is not important much for you. Okay. Okay. So this is all about hepatitis group of viruses. So I'll just show you certain treatment of a simplified view of the treatment of RSV virus. Respiratory syncytial virus, remember, it causes acute bronchiolitis, especially in preterm deliveries. It may also cause pneumonias. Normally, the treatment of RSV virus is supportive. We don't give any antiviral drug. Antiviral drug in respiratory syncytial virus is only indicated if the child which have been born is a premature, because it must be having some abnormal lung development. So if there is some abnormal or lung disease and a child is suffering from RSV virus, only then we give antiviral drug. The treatment for RSV virus will be aerosols of ribavirin, and for prevention we give a monoclonal antibody against RSV virus, that is pelivizumab. VI word is coming, V means virus. Okay, so try to remember. So how to remember? Prevention, P for pelivizumab for prevention. Okay, so this is about respiratory syncytial viruses. So keep this thing in mind. Let's solve certain questions. Okay, now the next question is the correct order of step for the different classes of antiretroviral. Antiretroviral, remember, is a class of drug which is given for HIV virus, because HIV is a type of retrovirus, because it converts its RNA into DNA. They exert influence. Now this is asking in which step we have developed the drug. So let's talk about HIV virus now. Okay, Now, let's see the structure of HIV virus first, then we will be discussing the drugs stepwise. We know the structure of an HIV virus. It contains an outer envelope in blue color. This outer envelope contains various glycoprotein. One of the glycoprotein you have to remember here is GP41. There are other glycoprotein like GP120, etc. So we have a drug, this GP41, remember it attaches to, GP stand for glycoprotein. It attaches to human receptors on cells, that is CD4, which is the main receptor, and co-receptor CXCR4 and CCR5. These are helping receptor or CXCR4, CCR5. So the first drug we have is GP41 inhibitor. Now the drug is, remember, GP41 is present on envelope of a virus. So the drug is N means envelope, Fu means fusion. It is inhibiting the fusion, Vir means virus tied. So enfuvirtide is a GP41 inhibitor. It is the only HIV drug which is given by injection. Okay? It is the only injectable HIV, anti-HIV drug. It is only given for HIV1 subtype, not HIV2. And it is known as fusion inhibitor. Then we have CCR5 inhibitor. The drug name is Maraviroc and Vicrivirok. They are known as entry inhibitor. They are oral drugs. Rest all other anti-HIV drugs are oral drug. Then we have a CD4 blocker. The monoclonal antibody is Ibalizumab. And lastly, we have CCR2 and CCR5 inhibitor Cenicriviroc, which is right now not an approved drug. Okay. Now, so the first is GP41, first step. Then we have CXCR4 and CD4. In this step, the first drug will be, on the left side is enfuvirtide. Then we have CXCR4. Now, let's see when this virus enters into the human cell. We know that HIV virus contains a single-stranded RNA. The single-stranded RNA gets converted into double-stranded DNA with the help of an enzyme, reverse transcriptase. Because normally transcription is DNA into RNA, but here RNA is forming into DNA, so it is known as reverse transcriptase. Can we call reverse transcriptase enzyme as RNA-dependent DNA polymerase? So reverse transcriptase is also known as RNA-dependent DNA polymerase. So it will form double-stranded DNA. Now this double-stranded DNA of virus will integrate, it will attach to the human DNA. So the enzyme will be integrase. And now this DNA will form its own viral protein with the help of enzymes of human cells. The viral protein will be formed, and this viral protein will assemble into complete HIV virus. For the assembly of viral protein, the virus requires an enzyme protease. Okay, so these are the three enzymes: RIP, RestGenPase, reverse transcriptase, integrase, and protease. So we have now three classes of drug. The first one is reverse transcriptase inhibitor, integrase inhibitor, and protease inhibitor. Okay. So in this fashion, the drug acts. So before going further, let's talk about the drug. The correct order of sequences. The first drug will be enfuvirtide. Yes, fusion inhibitor. Then there should be reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Remember, zidovudine is a reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Okay, efavirenz is also a reverse transcriptase inhibitor. And lastly, protease inhibitor. So the answer is A. Okay, the answer is A. Okay, so keeping this thing in mind, let's talk about all these three main classes of drug. Remember, these three drugs are the first line drug for HIV. The last drug which we have discussed, these were the new drugs for HIV. They are second line drug. They are only given as a salvage therapy in that cases when the patient is not responding to first line drug. So these are the three first line drug for HIV. Let's talk about the first drug, that is reverse transcriptase inhibitor. So reverse transcriptase inhibitor, they are the fake nucleoside analogs or fake nucleotide analog. So they are NRTI, nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor, NTRTI, NRTI, and non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, NNRTI. So nucleoside will be converted into nucleotide, so it requires phosphorylation, and nucleotide do not require phosphorylation. So first two drugs are competitive blocker, and they are effective against both HIV1 and 2. Non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, they don't require phosphorylation. They are non-competitive blocker. They attach to some different site. They are only effective against HIV1. So this is the complete list of antiretroviral drug, reverse transcriptase inhibitor, NRTI, NTRTI, and NNRTI. So the drugs among NRTIs are, the mnemonic is DAZALS: didanosine, abacavir, zidovudine, zalcitabine, emtricitabine, lamivudine, and cevudine. NTRTI, nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor, T for only one drug is there, tenofovir. NNRTI, remember the mnemonic is need relief. They will all will have VIR, vir word in between, nevirapine, efavirenz, itravirine, delavirine, and rilpinvirine. Integrase inhibitor, they will end with the word gravir. So the drug is RED, Raltegravir, Elvitagravir, and Dolutegravir. Lastly, we have this protease inhibitor. They will end with our NAVIR. The mnemonic is RAF Thailand, Ritonavir, Emprinavir, Fosamprinavir, Tipranavir, and Island. The drugs are written. They will end with our NAVIR. Okay? So these are the antiretroviral drugs. So let's talk about the first drug in great detail, that is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, DESLTS. Okay, nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, this drug, NRTI. So the common side effect is because they inhibit reverse transcriptase enzyme in virus, which is very similar to mitochondrial DNA polymerase enzyme. Okay, so the side effect is bone marrow suppression because mitochondria is required for cell division, myopathy because it is required for energy production, optic neuritis, peripheral neuropathy, pancreatitis, and insomnia. Now remember, maximum bone marrow suppression among all anti-HIV drug is caused by zidovudine, and it also mainly causes anemia, neutropenia. Okay, thrombocytopenia is least seen. Now it also causes peripheral neuropathy, maximum by cevudine, not seen with lamivudine, and maximum pancreatitis is caused by didanosine. So keeping this thing in mind, these are the specific side effects: cevudine, maximum peripheral neuropathy. As it inhibit mitochondria, so fatty acid oxidation will not be there, fats will accumulate, it will lead to hepatic fat accumulation, hepatic steatosis. If mitochondria is not working, it will lead to lactic acidosis because the Krebs cycle in mitochondria will not occur, so pyruvate will be converted into lactic acid. It will cause lipodystrophy as well because the fats will not be broken down, accumulation of fat will occur. Didanosine will cause maximum pancreatitis and optic neuritis. Zalcitabine causes oral ulcer. Abacavir is the drug which is only effective against HIV-1. Now remember, it causes severe hypersensitivity. Because of this reason, we should do HLA-B5701 testing before giving abacavir. Lamivudine causes pancreatitis. It is one of the safest NRTI because it does not cause peripheral neuropathy. And emtricitabine. Now this is about tenofovir anti-RTI. There are two sorts of tenofovir: tenofovir diproxyl and elafenamide. Elafenamide is overall less toxic. It causes Fanconi syndrome. In Fanconi syndrome, the PCT of kidney will not function. So phosphate will be lost, which will lead to hypophosphatemic rickets or osteoporosis. The safest NRTI in renal failure are zidovudine and abacavir. HIV and HIV common drug are, we have already discussed. The combination of NRTI which should be avoided are given in the notes, so we will be discussing about them so shortly. Okay, cevudine, didanosine, zalcitabine. Now NNRTI, if you talk about, they will end with a word, they will have vir word in between. They are only effective against HIV-1. Their common side effect is rashes, skin rashes, and Stevens-Johnson syndrome, toxic epidermolytic necrosis, also known as SJSTN. Now the drugs are need relief: nevirapine, efavirine, zitravirine, delavirine, and rilpivirine. Okay, so nevirapine, remember, N for nevirapine, it is a drug of choice for neonatal prophylaxis or to prevent vertical transmission. Efavirine, remember, it causes psychosis. It is the only anti-HIV drug which was found to be teratogenic, but right now it is not teratogenic. It is given in pregnancy. No anti-HIV drug is contraindicated in pregnancy. Other drugs are already given. There are two drugs which causes QT prolongation: rilpivirine and an protease inhibitor, saquinavir. Then we have integrase inhibitor. They inhibit attachment of HIV DNA to the host DNA. So they inhibit strand transfer of DNA to host DNA. The drugs, they will end with the word Gravir. Red are the drugs. Okay. Raltegravir, Elvitagravir, and Dolutegravir. Okay. So generally we increase the level of Elvitagravir by combining with the drug known as Cobicistat. Cobicistat inhibit the degradation of Elvitagravir by inhibiting CYP3A4 enzyme. Cobicistat is also combined with other anti-HIV drug. The drugs are Elvitagravir, Darunavir, and Atazanavir. Now let's talk about protease inhibitor. Protease inhibitor, they inhibit assembly of viral protein. They all end with the word NAVIR. The mnemonic is RAF Thailand. Now their common side effect is, remember, they cause GIT upset. Their main side effect is three. This is very important for you. They cause hyperlipidemia. They increase cholesterol, LDL level, and triglyceride, which is not seen with Atazanavir. Insulin resistance and lipodystrophy. In lipodystrophy, they may cause accumulation of fat in breast and central obesity. And these are the specific side effects: ritonavir, it causes paresthesia. It increases the toxicity of other drug because it is a CYP inhibitor. Tipranavir. Indinavir causes renal stones. Saquinavir causes QT prolongation. Atazanavir causes hyperbilirubinemia. Now remember, all protease inhibitor are CYP substrate inhibitor. Ritonavir is maximum. except nelfinavir. That is why ritonavir is combined with other protease inhibitor to increase their effect, to boost their effect. The combination of ritonavir with other protease inhibitor is known as boosted PI, but it is never combined with nelfinavir. Okay, and this ritonavir can increase the toxicity of other CYP substrate like benzodiazepine, like midazolam. Okay, these are the certain new drugs for HIV. For diarrhea, we give octreotidin, crofelemer. Lipodystrophy, we give tesamorelin. And maturation inhibitor are bevirimat and vivecon. Now, these are the guidelines of HIV. NACP, National AIDS Control Program. Remember, now antiretroviral drug ART are given to all HIV patients irrespective of CD4 count. No drug is contraindicated in pregnancy. Earlier, efavirenz was contraindicated. Remember, now efavirenz is the drug of choice in pregnancy. Now, at least we have to give 3 anti-HIV drug from at least 2 different classes. Most commonly, we use TEL regimen, TEL, tenofovir, efavirenz and lamivudine. Instead of efavirenz, we can change it with dolutegravir, because efavirenz is an NNRTI. It is only effective against HIV-1. Now, for neonatal prophylaxis, we give nevirapine, and for post-operative exposure prophylaxis, which is given for 4 weeks or 28 days, we can give same TEL therapy, or we can give same zidovudine, lamivudine and indinavir therapy. So this is all about the antiviral drugs. Let's solve all these questions now, keeping this thing in mind. Which of the following is not a nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor? I have told you the mnemonic DASLs. Okay, D for didanosine, A for abacavir, Z for zidovudine, Z for zalcitabine, E for emtricitabine, L for lamivudine, and S for chavudine. So which of the following is not given? Remember, nevirapine. Okay, try to find. It is having vir word in between. Vir word is coming in between. The answer will be, it is an NNRTI. Okay. All of the following are protease inhibitor. Remember, all protease inhibitor will end with the word navir. So which is not ending with the word navir? The answer is abacavir. Okay. Which of the following is a protease inhibitor? Try to find the word navir. The answer is etazanavir. So you don't have to apply much of the concept out here. Now, which of the following is not true for antiretroviral? The drug which is CCR5 antagonist, maraviroc and vicriviroc, yes, we have discussed, true. Integrase inhibitor, they will end with the word gravir, yes, true. Maturation inhibitor, beviramat, it's true. Mat word is coming, so maturation. As you are seeing, mat word is coming. Mat means maturation. NNRTI, they will have vir word in between, yes, true. Protease inhibitor, emtricitabine, false. Remember, emtricitabine is not a protease inhibitor. All protease inhibitor will end with the word navir. Emtricitabine is rather an NRTI. Okay. Which of the following can be used in both HIV and HBV? I have told you 3 drugs are there which are found to be effective against HIV as well as HBV. That is lamivudine, emtricitabine, they are effective, and tenofovir. But remember, emtricitabine right now, it is effective against HBV, but it is not approved for HBV. It is not approved for HBV. So the answer out here is tenofovir, which is given. Lamivudine, which is given. So the answer will be both A and B. So the answer will be both A and B. Resistance due to zidovudine will develop due to. Now, resistance to zidovudine generally develops due to mutation in reverse transcriptase enzyme. The answer is very logical answer, because zidovudine is a reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Hence, mutation in reverse transcriptase enzyme leads to resistance to zidovudine. Now, which of the following is correct? Indinavir, etazanavir causes unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia. The answer is true. We have already discussed the specific side effect of protease inhibitor. I'll just show you that slide again. So see, indinavir and etazanavir. Etazanavir causes hyperbilirubinemia, also by indinavir. It's absolutely true statement. Tipranavir is a non-peptide protease inhibitor. We know that it is ending with the word navir. Yes, it is a protease inhibitor. Nelfinavir metabolism is not inhibited by ritonavir. True, we have already discussed, because nelfinavir, N word is coming. It is the only protease inhibitor which is not a substrate of CYP3A4. While ritonavir generally inhibits CYP3A4, zelsitabine causes oral ulcer. We have already discussed, yes, NNRTI. So the answer will be all of the above. So remember, in HIV, the side effects of anti-HIV drugs are very important. Okay? Now, which of the following is not correctly matched? Zidovudine causes bone marrow suppression. Yes, it is the most common anti-HIV drug which causes bone marrow suppression. Didanosine causes maximum pancreatitis. Cevudine causes maximum neuropathy. Remember, lamivudine does not cause peripheral neuropathy. It also causes pancreatitis. So the answer we have discussed is lamivudine. Which of the following is correctly matched? NRTI, mitochondrial toxicity, yes. NNRTI, rashes and Stevens-Johnson, true. Protease inhibitor, lipodystrophy, true. We have already discussed, so the answer will be all of the above. Which of the following is correctly matched? Zidovudine causes sulfonamide hypersensitivity. The answer is, zidovudine causes sulfonamide hypersensitivity. The answer is false. It is not a sulfa drug. Ampirinavir, nail pigmentation, no, we haven't discussed. Ritonavir causes renal stone, false. Remember, it is rather indinavir which causes renal stone. The answer out here is tenofovir causes renal failure. Yes, we have discussed. Tenofovir causes Fanconi syndrome, which is the characteristic side effect. Fanconi syndrome. Fanconi syndrome, there is damage to, there is PCT, malfunctioning, the proximal convoluted tubule in kidney is not functioning, which can lead to phosphate and calcium loss, which can lead to osteoporosis. All of the following antiretroviral drug produces dyslipidemia. Remember, dyslipidemia is the main side effect of protease inhibitor. Except one protease inhibitor which does not cause dyslipidemia, we have already discussed, except etazanavir. Okay? Etazanavir does not cause dyslipidemia. So the answer out here will be etazanavir. Drug which is not safe in pregnancy in HIV is efavirenz, but remember, it's an old concept. Efavirenz is teratogenic in animals, but remember, it is now safe in human. And you have to write one point, that no anti-HIV drug is contraindicated in pregnancy. All anti-HIV drugs can be given in pregnancy. Okay? Which of the following is true for non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, that is NNRTI? We have discussed that NNRTI are non-competitive inhibitors. It's absolutely true statement. It is only effective against HIV-1. It's absolutely true statement. They do not require intracellular phosphorylation. It's absolutely true statement. And they show cross-resistance. It's absolutely true statement. We have already discussed. So I'll show you that slide again to recall that point about NNRTI. So NNRTI, we have already discussed that NNRTI, they don't require phosphorylation, they are non-competitive inhibitor, and they are only effective against HIV-1. So you can see. And remember about NNRTI, the cross resistance among them is very common. That is why we have developed itravirine, which is even effective in resistant cases of other NNRTI. Okay, so remember this part. Now, false about protease inhibitor in HIV infection is, they are powerful enzyme inhibitors. It's absolutely true. It is maximum seen with ritonavir. Ritonavir is a very powerful CYP inhibitor. All other protease inhibitors, saquinavir is the most potent inhibitor. No, most potent inhibitor of CYP is ritonavir. So this is a false statement. So the false statement is B. They all cause hepatotoxicity. They may cause hepatotoxicity. The question for this is, yes, rarely they may cause. Yes. Okay. All protease inhibitors are the substrate of P-glycoprotein encoded by multi-drug resistance gene. Yes, true. We have discussed. I have shown you that slide. Now, an HIV positive patient is on antiretroviral therapy with zidovudine, lamivudine and indinavir. He is proven to be suffering from genitourinary tuberculosis. Which of the following drugs should not be given to this patient? The answer for this question is rifampicin. Rifampicin, remember, is a CYP 3A4 inducer. it will increase the degradation of HIV drugs. So in that cases, rather give rifabutin. So that part I have already told you in TB, rather give rifabutin. So the main problem with HIV with TB is rifampicin. The contraindication of amantadine includes all of the following except. The answer for this question is, remember, peptic ulcer is not an absolute contraindication, it is a relative contraindication. While other are absolute contraindication. Okay? So the answer out here will be peptic ulcers. Now, which of the following statement is false about acyclovir? Acyclovir inhibit DNA synthesis and viral replication. True, yes, because it was a fake guanine analog. We have already discussed. It is effective against influenza. Remember, it is ending with the word cyclovir. Cyclovir means herpes group of virus. So this is a false statement. It has low toxicity for host cells. The answer is true because it is only activated by viral thymidine kinase. Renal impairment, necessitates dose reduction. Yes, its main side effect was nephrotoxic and neurotoxic. So that is why in renal toxicity, dose must be reduced. So the answer out here will be, it is not effective against influenza. It is for herpes group of virus. Mechanism of acyclovir resistance is, we have already discussed, it is due to altered specificity of thymidine kinase. Okay. Altered specificity of thymidine kinase, it is the most common cause of resistance. But remember, other effects are also seen. Other effects are also seen. You will go by the answer, all of the above. For the complete concept, you can see the whole video. Okay? But the main mechanism of resistance is B, but you will go by the answer D. Okay? So DNA polymerase sometimes gets mutated. Okay? Also, a 29-year-old female diagnosed with AIDS have been suffering from progressive blurring of vision in her right eye. On fundoscopic examination, small white opaque lesion is seen on retina or on right eye. The most appropriate, remember, it is some type of a opportunistic infection in AIDS. This is known as CMV retinitis. This is the classical feature of CMV retinitis. Okay? Small white opaque lesion is seen on retina. Okay? So cytomegalovirus, the drug of choice for cytomegalovirus was ganciclovir. Which is not used as an anti-herpes drug? The answer is nelfinavir. Nelfinavir word is coming, so it's a protease inhibitor. And it is given against HIV. Okay? So cyclovir word is coming, so it will be anti-herpes drug. Foscarnet is given in resistant cases of acyclovir and ganciclovir. Now, which of the following drug does not act against cytomegalovirus? The answer was acyclovir. Okay? So the drug of choice for CMV was ganciclovir. In resistant cases, we give foscarnet and cidofovir. Acyclovir is not effective against cytomegalovirus. Now, idoxuridine. We have discussed that idoxuridine is a topical drug for herpes simplex virus 1 and 2. It is given for herpes labialis and herpes keratitis, corneal ulcers. Remember, it is not given orally because it is highly cardiotoxic. That is why it is not given orally. It is only given topically. Now, what is the idoxuridine? As the word uridine is coming, it is a fake uridine analog. And because of this reason, it inhibits DNA replication. So, fake uridine. Uridine is a part of DNA and RNA. Uridine gets converted into thymidine. Okay, uridine gets converted into thymidine. So, let's talk about this question now in great detail. It is analog of thymidine. The answer is true because uridine gets converted into thymidine in the synthesis of DNA. It is too toxic for routine systemic use. The answer is true. That is why, because it is highly cardiotoxic. It inhibits the replication of some RNA virus by causing the synthesis of fraudulent viral protein. Remember, it is not given for RNA viruses. It is only given for herpes group of virus. And herpes group of virus is a DNA virus. Okay, so the C statement is a false statement. So C is a false statement. Now it is used for topical treatment of herpes simplex infection of skin and cornea like labialis and keratitis. The answer is absolutely true. Okay, now which of the following antiviral drugs cannot be given orally? So I have already told you the mnemonic, vitamin CD. Okay, I'll just show you that slide again. Okay, so the drugs which are not given orally, the drugs which are given topically for the treatment of herpes group of virus were these drugs. Okay, so these are the topical drug. You are seeing idoxuridine is out here, so the answer will be idoxuridine. Okay, it is given for herpes simplex virus. Which of the following is not a side effect of acyclovir? Remember, acyclovir causes neurotoxicity and it is nephrotoxic. In nephrotoxic, it causes crystallinuria. And same is the side effect of foscarnet, the resistant cases. We were giving a drug, foscarnet. But remember, it is not myelotoxic. Myelotoxic means bone marrow suppression. It is not myelotoxic. Both are not myelotoxic or bone marrow suppression. Remember, bone marrow suppression is the main side effect of ganciclovir and cidofovir, which were given in CMV virus and resistant cases. Okay, so the answer will be bone marrow suppression. Which of the following is not correct? The dose limiting toxicity of ganciclovir is myelosuppression. Yes, we have already discussed. The dose limiting toxicity of acyclovir is myelosuppression. False. We have already discussed. The dose limiting toxicity of cidofovir is nephrotoxicity. Yes, it may cause. Foscarnet can cause nephrotoxicity and loss of all ions. Yes, it may cause. Okay. Acyclovir does not cause bone marrow suppression. Now, drug of choice for acute bronchiolitis. Acute bronchiolitis, remember, is caused by respiratory syncytial virus. For respiratory syncytial virus treatment, the drug is ribavirin. And for prophylaxis, we develop a monoclonal antibody. Try to remember that drug I have told you. Palivizumab. Okay, P for prophylaxis, VI for virus, Zumab. Okay. So the answer out here, you will convert the mark the correct answer as ribavirin. Which of the following is incorrectly matched? Teratogenic phenytoin causes cleft lip and cleft palate. Absolutely true. Okay. Valproate causes neural tube defect. True. ACE inhibitors causes renal defect. Yes, they are teratogenic. Remember, zidovudine is not a teratogenic drug, so it's a false statement. All anti-HIV drugs are given in pregnancy. All of the following are the common adverse effect of heart therapy. Heart stands for highly active antiretroviral therapy. It is given for HIV. Steatosis. So the answer, let's find out the answer out here is. It causes steatosis. Yes, it is the most common, it is the common side effect of NRTI. Lipodystrophy. Yes, it's a common side effect of protease inhibitor. Optic neuritis, remember, it is not the common side effect. It is the rarest form of common side effect. It is very rare. Increased cholesterol, yes, it's a common side effect of protease inhibitor. Efavirenz is used for the treatment of HIV infection. Vir word is coming in between. So it's an NNRTI. Non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Go by the answer B. It is a reverse transcriptase. Which of the following is integrase inhibitor? Integrase inhibitor, they will end with the word Gravir. So I have already told you the drug will be Raltegravir. Which of the following drug is a reverse transcriptase inhibitor? So all are ending with the word Navir. Navir will be protease inhibitor. So the answer out here will be Abacavir. The basis of combining ritonavir with lopinavir is, remember, lopinavir is a CYP3A4 inhibitor and lopinavir gets degraded or metabolized by CYP3A4 enzyme. Hence, it will increase the level of lopinavir by inhibiting degradation. This type of combination is known as boosted protease inhibitor or boosted PI. So the answer will be CYP3A4 inhibition by ritonavir. Okay, drug causing maximum peripheral neuropathy was cevudine. I have already told you. Cevudine. So the answer will be cevudine. Which of the following antiretroviral drug does not cause peripheral neuropathy? Not by lamivudine. Okay, so the answer will be lamivudine. Resistance to zidovudine develops due to? It was due to mutation in reverse transcriptase enzyme. We know that zidovudine is a reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Okay, nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors are? The answer is zelsitabine, true. Nevirapine, where word is coming in between? No. Dilavirdin, where word is coming in between? No, because they are NNRTI. Cevudine, true. Ritonavir, no. It is ending with the word navir, so it's a protease inhibitor. So the answer is A and D. That is zelsitabine and cevudine. Remember the mnemonic DASLS I have told you. Among NNRTI, I have told you the mnemonic DASLS. So try to remember that mnemonic. Bone marrow suppression drug in treatment of HIV are, remember, they are mainly NRTI. NRTI causes bone marrow suppression. So try to find bone marrow suppression, NRTI. We have already discussed among herpes group of virus, ganciclovir was causing bone marrow suppression. So didanosine, true, zidovudine, true, zelsitabine, true, and ganciclovir. So they all cause bone marrow suppression. Because A, B, and C are NRTI. And ganciclovir is an herpes group of virus. It also causes bone marrow suppression. Now, the next point is, okay. Now, in AIDS patient, remember, ganciclovir is given for the treatment of opportunistic infection. It is not given for HIV virus. It is given for cytomegalovirus. Now, protease inhibitor are, they will end with the word navir. So, try to find the word navir. Saquinavir, nelfinavir, nevirapine. So these are the answers. Select the drug which is active against both HIV and HBV. We have already discussed that mnemonic, LET, LET, lamivudine, it, emtricitabine, and tenofovir. So the answer will be lamivudine. Which of the following drug inhibit post-translational modification of viral protein? So they are protease inhibitor. They inhibit assembly of viral protein. Okay, so the protease inhibitor will end with the word navir. Answer will be indinavir. A patient with AIDS with CD4 count of 100, persistent fever, weight loss associated with Mycobacterium avium complex. Management of this Mycobacterium avium complex is, I have already told you, the treatment of MAC infection, the drugs are KRFQ. The drugs which are used for MAC infection are KRFQ, clarithromycin. And the brother of clarithromycin or azithromycin. We give rifabutin, ethambutol. In resistant cases, we have fluoroquinolone like ciprofloxacin, levofloxacin, etc. So these are the drugs which are given for MAC infection. So the answer will be, treat the patient with clarithromycin, ethambutol, and rifabutin. So C is the correct answer. Which of the following drug is most likely to be cause additive anemia, neutropenia, when administered to AIDS patient? Remember, zidovudine and NRTI, they cause bone marrow suppression. And which anti-herpes drug I have told you which causes bone marrow suppression was ganciclovir. Ganciclovir causes bone marrow suppression. Because of this reason, ganciclovir and zidovudine should never be combined, because it can lead to marked bone marrow suppression or neutropenia. So the answer out here will be ganciclovir. Okay, zidovudine causes, the main side effect of zidovudine we have already discussed, causes bone marrow suppression or neutropenia. Okay, bone marrow suppression which can lead to neutropenia. Which of the following is most common side effect of zidovudine? The answer is all of the above. So these are the common side effect of NNRTI, which I have already told you. Okay, all of the above. Okay, but if you want to discuss among them, the most common is bone marrow suppression, which can lead to anemia. This will be the most common. Okay, so if the question is asking specifically most common, then you will go by the answer anemia, not by the answer D, because the question is asking about most common, but remember all are seen. But the most common is bone marrow suppression. Which of the following anti-HIV drugs should never be given as re-challenge once the history of producing allergic reaction is known? That was abacavir. I have already told you. Remember, abacavir, the main side effect is it causes fatal hypersensitivity. And before giving abacavir, remember, we should do testing. That testing is known as HLA B505701 testing should be done. Okay, in these HLA positive individual, it may cause fatal hypersensitivity. Which protease inhibitor has a boosting effect? Boosting effect is by ritonavir because it inhibits CYP3A4 enzyme. Which of the following drug act against HIV-2 except? Remember, the drugs which are not effective against HIV-2 are, there are three classes of HIV drug. One is NNRTI. Second is enfuvirtide. And the last drug which is not effective against HIV-2 is abacavir. So these drugs are not effective against HIV. They are only given against HIV-1 virus. Rest all other anti-HIV drug are effective against both. So all NNRTI, they will have a vir word in between. So the answer is efavirenz. Because efavirenz is having vir word in between, it is a type of NNRTI. Okay. Drug which produces Stevens-Johnson syndrome. Stevens-Johnson syndrome is the common side effect of NNRTI. We have already discussed. Okay. But right now, NNRTI is not given. It is also a side effect of one tuberculosis anti-tubercular drug, that is thioacetazone. Remember, thioacetazone, that is why it is absolutely contraindicated in HIV. It may produce severe hypersensitivity in HIV individuals only. So the answer is thioacetazone is never given. It is the only anti-tubercular drug which is not given in HIV individual. The HIV fusion inhibitor, enfuvirtide. Envelope fusion inhibitor, it was active against GP41. So we have already discussed GP41 inhibitor. All of the following antiretroviral drug produces dyslipidemia. Remember, dyslipidemia is the main side effect of protease inhibitor. And but which protease inhibitor was not producing dyslipidemia? That was etazanavir. More than 90% of this drug is excreted in urine in intact form. Because of urinary solubility is low, the patient should be well hydrated to prevent nephrotoxicity. So can you tell me which protease inhibitor was producing renal stones because of deposition? That was indinavir. Okay, it was causing renal stones. So the answer is indinavir. Okay. Now, the drug of choice in herpes simplex encephalitis. Remember, herpes simplex word virus will come. Blindly mark the answer, acyclovir. Okay. Herpes simplex. A person is being treated for HIV virus. He developed hypertriglyceridemia and hypercholesterolemia. So there is hyperlipidemia. Hyperlipidemia is the common side effect of protease inhibitor. Okay, so the answer for protease inhibitor, they will end with the word navir. All protease inhibitor, they will end with the word navir. So the answer will be ritonavir. Which of the following drug is used to prevent transmission of HIV from HIV positive mother to child? Remember, for neonatal transmission in neonates, so that it should not come from breast milk, we give N for nevirapine. Nevirapine syrups. A neonate nevirapine syrup, easy to remember. So go by the answer nevirapine. All of the following cause inhibition of CYP3A4 except inhibition. The drug which will not inhibit CYP3A4, ritonavir true, erythromycin true, itraconazole true. The answer is sequinavir. Sequinavir is the only protease inhibitor which will not inhibit CYP3A4. For the complete list of CYP3A4 inhibitor, you can refer to the complete videos of general pharmacology. I have told you a mnemonic also. Okay. So the CYP3A4 inhibitor, the drugs are Coke, IVC, GAP. Okay. So the C for cimetidine. Only cimetidine, not ranitidine. O for omeprazole and all azoles. Sorry, omeprazole and all PPI. Ketoconazole. And all azoles like itraconazole, etc. Erythromycin, but not azithromycin. Isoniazid. Valproate. Ciproflox. Ciprofloxacin, grapefruit juice. Amiodarone. And allopurinol. Protease inhibitors, which is ritonavir, but not saquinavir. Okay, so this is the complete list. Maximum risk of pancreatitis is by didanosine. I have already told you in that list. Okay, NNRTI. Nevirapine, remember vir word is coming in between, so it is an NNRTI. That is non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. All of the following are protease inhibitor except they will end with our navir, except will be abacavir. True about protease inhibitors are they are substrate of P-glycoprotein. The answer is true. They undergo hepatic oxidative metabolism, yes, which is mediated by CYP3A4. The answer is true. They interfere with the metabolism of servier drug, yes, because they are CYP3A4 inhibitor. Saquinavir causes maximum induction of CYP. This is a false statement. Remember, saquinavir have no induction or inhibiting property on CYP3A4 enzyme. Complication of zidovudine therapy are, the answer is nausea, vomiting, true. It is seen with oral drug. Anemia, bone marrow suppression, hepatic steatosis, true. So these are the first three statements are true. Remember, it has no effect on kidney. It is one of the safest anti-HIV drug in renal failure. Zidovudine is the safest drug. It has no effect on heart. Okay. Regarding ritonavir used in AIDS patient, all of the following are true. So the answer is it interferes with terbinafine. Yes, because terbinafine is a CYP3A4 substrate. See the videos of General Pharma, I've told you. So the answer is true. And ritonavir inhibits CYP3A4 enzyme. GI symptoms are seen. Yes, all oral drugs can show nausea, vomiting and diarrhea. True. There it is contraindicated in renal failure. Now this is a false statement. It is NNRTI. It is again a false statement. It is rather a protease inhibitor. It should not be given in AIDS patient with bleeding disorder. It is a false statement. Okay. No indication. I haven't told you anything of this. So the answer is A and B. Drug used for the treatment of chorioretinitis in AIDS, which is caused by CMV virus. The drug of choice for CMV virus is ganciclovir. In resistant cases of ganciclovir, we give foscarnet, we give cedofovir, and a new drug for CMV retinitis is fomivirsen and letermovir. So this is the complete list of the drugs for CMV virus. So the answer you are finding out here is ganciclovir and cedofovir. Okay. Which of the following statement about chavudine is accurate? The bone marrow suppression is dose limiting. Okay. It is false. Remember, the dose limiting is mainly by zidovudine. Bone marrow suppression is the most common dose limiting side effect of zidovudine. It causes marked neurotoxicity. True. It is the drug which causes maximum neurotoxicity is chavudine. Okay. So this is a true statement. It is an HIV protease. False. Remember, protease inhibitor are generally navir word. It is rather an NRTI. Nucleoside reverse transcript. It is an NNRTI. Again, it is a false statement. It is rather an NNRTI. So the answer is B. Efavirenz limits HIV infection is, we know that efavirenz, it binds to allosteric site of HIV transcriptase because allosteric inhibitors are non-competitive inhibitor. And remember, efavirenz is an NNRTI, and I have told you NNRTI are non-competitive inhibitors of reverse transcriptase enzyme. Now, which of the following bind to viral envelope glycoprotein blocks conformational changes required for fusion of viral? So the drug I have already told you was enfuvirtide. Okay. In accidental needle stick injury, unknown quantity of blood from the AIDS patient is injected to the nurse. Recent report shows that the patient is having CD4 count of 20. That means very less and greater than 4 viral load. So we have to give post-exposure prophylaxis for 4 weeks or 28 days. Okay, with 3 drugs. Generally, this drug will be TEL therapy, or it will be zidovudine, lamivudine and indinavir combination. Okay, so the answer for this question will come out to be, the question number 494 will come out to be, administer zidovudine and lamivudine for 4 weeks. So this is the best statement. Let's see why. Monitor nurse blood whether HIV transmission has occurred. This is a false statement. We will not monitor, we will not wait. Treat with full dose of zidovudine for 4 weeks. This is a false statement. We give for 4 weeks. Acyclovir is added to zidovudine. Remember, false. There is no addition of acyclovir. Acyclovir is anti-herpes drug. So the best statement among this 4 will be D. Zidovudine and didanosine used in the heart therapy are act by. They are NRTI. They are nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Which of the following statement about lamivudine is false? It possesses anti-HIV and HPV property. It's absolutely true. We have discussed already. Okay. So it has both anti-HIV and HPV property. I've told you 3 drug LET, LET. Lamivudine, emtricitabine and tenofovir. Lower dose of blocking HIV replication occurs. Remember, it is a false statement. It requires equal dose. The dose of HIV and HBV is both same. Okay, the lower dose is not required. Should not be used in monotherapy. Yes, it should not be given as a monotherapy. Remember, we always give combination of drug in HIV patient to prevent the development of resistance. Anti-HBV seroconversion is seen in minority of patient. It's absolutely true. If the patient of HBV comes with HBE infection, the best treatment will be interferons. Interferons alpha causes maximum seroconversion. So it is a true statement that lamivudine cannot cause seroconversion. So a laboratory technician was accidentally exposed to HIV, so you have to give post-exposure prophylaxis. The role of zidovudine in the treatment is to protect against HIV. So simple question. All are protease inhibitor except tenofovir. All protease inhibitor will end with the word navir. Okay. Which of the following is a protease inhibitor? Find the word navir, saquinavir. Enfuvirtide belongs to fusion inhibitor. Okay, it inhibits envelope fusion. It is a GP41 inhibitor. In antiretroviral therapy, zidovudine should not be combined with. Remember, zidovudine should not be combined with cevudine. Okay, so let's talk about which combination of anti-HIV drugs should not be given together. So let's talk about which of the following anti-HIV drugs should not be given together. So the answer for this question is zidovudine plus cevudine. So this NRTI combination should not be given. Remember, the last one, zidovudine and cevudine should not be given because they show cross resistance. They have same common mode of resistance. Lamivudine and emtricitabine should not be given because they also show cross resistance. The resistance is due to M184 position. The valine will be converted into some other, will be incorporated with some other amino acid. Okay. And in that cases, with lamivudine and emtricitabine, to prevent development of resistance, we always combine zidovudine and tenofovir. Then cevudine, didanosine and zalcitabine should not be combined because they have similar toxicities. Okay. So these combinations should never be given in HIV. So here zidovudine should not be given with cevudine, because of cross resistance. They both have common cause of resistance. Viral integrase inhibitor, integrase, the word will be gravir. So the answer will be gravir. So the answer will be raltegravir. And lastly, we will have antiretroviral drug, which is also effective against hepatitis B. So HIV with B, the answer was lamivudine, L-E-T, let. We have already discussed. The drug most likely to be responsible for acute pancreatitis, the most common cause, maximum drug with acute pancreatitis was didanosine. Okay, didanosine. I'll just show you that list again. Okay. So stavudine causes maximum peripheral neuropathy, hepatic steatosis, lactic acidosis and lipodystrophy because of inhibition of mitochondrial DNA polymerase. Didanosine causes maximum pancreatitis and optic neuritis. Abacavir causes fatal hypersensitivity. Lamivudine does not cause peripheral neuropathy. So the answer out here is acute pancreatitis. The answer will be didanosine. Okay? Didanosine. Okay? So this is all about all antiviral drugs. So thank you very much. For the complete concepts, you can see the subscription of complete videos. Okay?